Very good morning, cadets. Today, let us start the chapter number 1 from history. That is how, when, and where. In chapter number 1, history, that is how, when, and where, we are going to study about few major topics. The topic number 1 is periodization of history, that is division of history on the basis of various periods, that is what you studied in class 7, that is ancient history, medieval Indian history and modern Indian history. Apart from that, we are also going to study about James Mill classification of history and his classification of history written in the book The History of British India. Then we are also going to study about the survey system introduced by the British. Then what are the problems? What are the problems of Mill's classification of history? And finally, how the historical records and records in other places are different from police station or other records. That is what we are going to study. So chapter is very small chapter. We are mainly studying about Mill's classification of history and the problems of Mill's classification of history. So which date, the criteria? So criteria or date which we select to compose our history is important. They become vital because we focus on particular set of event as important. For example, Stone Age period. Why Stone Age period? Because those days the people who belongs to that period mainly focused on primary weapons which is available to the people, like stones. Later only they started settle down and started agriculture job. So few important events, based on that we divide history into various periods. So that is what we say, periodization. Whenever we refer British Indian history, please remember this name, Warren Hastings. Warren Hastings is the first Governor General of India. So first Governor General, who is the first Governor General of India? Lord Warren Hastings. So he, the first Governor General of India, he assumed power in the year 1773. Now try to understand the post of Governor General was there till the first war of Indian independence, that is till 1857. So after 1857, the leaders of British company in India, they were called as viceroys. Means they were the viceroys of British Queen. So prior to that, they are called as Governor Generals. So first Governor General is Lord Warren Hastings. He is the first Governor General of British East India Company. So now let us move to the next important topic, periodization of history by James Mill. Please remember, James Mill, who periodized, classified history in the year 1817. James Mill, who belongs to Scotland, that's why he's called a Scottish, who belonged to Scotland, so he was a Scottish. He was expert in economics, so economics, that's why he was called as economist and political philosopher. So James Mill
in 1817 published a massive volume of work called as History of British India. So who wrote the book History of British India? The book History of British India written by James Mill in 1817. In the History of British India, James Mill divided Indian history into three periods. They are Hindu, Muslim and British. Now, if you recall what you studied last year, Indian history is divided into three periods, but this division of history is purely ancient history, medieval Indian history and modern Indian history. But what is this classification? You see, Hindu, Muslim and British. This classification is the classification given by James Mill. So James Mill's classification of history into three periods: Hindu, Muslim and British. Now let us check what happened to this classification. Why we are not studying this classification? He tried to divide history on the basis of religion. He argued that in the first half of first periodization, it is Hindu kings ruled. The second periodization, it is the Muslim ruled, and third British ruled. But we are not studying Mill's classification of history. So why we don't study Mill's classification of history? Because it got its own problems. What are the problems of Mill's classification of history? Mill's classification of history, please write down the problem of Mill's classification of history. He felt that Asian societies were at lower level of civilization than Europe. So James Mill felt that Europe, that is Britain especially, their civilization is very high. So civilization of Asia is very very lower than Europe. And according to James Mill, before British came to India, Hindu, Muslim despots ruled the country. So now you understood what's the problem of Mill's classification. Mill said that before British landed in India, the Hindu and Muslim despots are nothing but dictators who never cared for the feelings and emotions of the people. So he said that Hindu and Muslim despots ruled the country, and religious intolerance. So James Mill says that before British arrived to India, in India there was no tolerance, means one religion was not tolerating other religion, and Indian society was full of caste taboos and superstitious practice dominated the social life. So now try to understand what is the Mill's classification of history got a problem. One major problem, Mill said that Hindu Muslim rulers were despot. That cannot be accepted, because several Hindu kings, they were very benevolent, they were very good to the people. That's why they even given a biggest titles like Hoysala Kingdom, Hoysala Vishnuvardhana, Pulakeshi of Chalukya dynasty, Krishna the second of Rashtrakuta dynasty, Amoghorsa Nupatunga, Chandragupta Maurya. Name any few major Indian kings. They were all very very good to the people. They were not despots. At the same time, he says there was a religious intolerance. If you remember the story of Akbar and Birbal, and Akbar's famous religion called Deen-e-Ilahi, or in Akbar's court, Akbar entertained or allowed the people from or the religious gurus from all other religion. Maybe one or two kings were despots, or they may be religious intolerant, but not all. So this cannot be accepted. And India was not completely superstitious. That is also cannot be accepted. So Mill felt that British could civilize India. So Mill says that the rule of British is very important. Why? Because they will civilize India. So they say that Mill says that it is important to introduce European manners, European art, European institution and law in India. In fact, suggested that British should conquer all the territories in India to ensure enlightenment and happiness with the Indian people. Now you understand how much James Mill was pro towards his civilization. This is what Indian history is misinterpreted by the British. So you see the audacity of his. He says that in British should rule entire India. Why? To enlighten and provide happiness. Whereas the Gautam Buddha, who of course a person with enlightenment, Shankaracharya, Madhvacharya, many religious leaders who got enlightenment in India, it all belongs to India. That's what we say. Destroying the history and the culture of a country, that is what the British mainly done. So now you maybe understood that why we cannot accept James Mill's classification of history, because James Mill wanted to justify the rule of the British, but the reason given for justification cannot be accepted. So his idea of British rule represented the force and progress and civilization. The period before British rule was one more reason. Now you see, James Mill said that the rule before the British was full of darkness. Now how can you say Indian period was darkness? Because the best civilization of the world is of course in India only. That's the reason this cannot be accepted. And one more division of period as Hindus and Muslims, it cannot be taken, because variety of faiths exist simultaneously in these period. For example, you studied in class 7th that we had the in Hinduism itself Dvaita, Advaita, Vishishta Advaita, even the Bhakti tradition, okay, Jainism, Buddhism, Sikh, Islam. So in India, several other religions were also predominantly existed. So this cannot be taken into consideration. So Mill's view cannot be taken into consideration. So because we rejected the Mill's period, that's the reason why we study today this model. What model? Indian history can be divided into ancient, medieval and modern. But ancient, medieval, modern period, this also got a problem. Now what's the problem? Now you see, ancient, medieval and modern. Why they say modern? Because they feel that rule during the time of British, it is considered as time of modernity, because they say science, reason, democracy, liberty and equality, it was started during the modern period or the British period. But this also cannot be taken as it is, because in India the science and tradition, for example, if you visit Ajanta and Ellora, the paintings of Ajanta are so scientific. Even today, after almost 2000 years, nothing has happened to those paintings. So that means Indians had a fantastic idea of certain components which could make a fantastic painting or a painting content. Like that Konark temple or any other temple, including Belur, Halabid or Badami, Rock Cut caves and all those things. So there is enough example of modernity in Indian art and architecture or the buildings. But the British want to project that, the projection of science, reason, democracy started with the British. So this is what you should understand, that, and British said that they were supporting ideas of equality. But British rule never supported ideas of equality. They never gave freedom or liberty to the Indians. That's the reason why even Mahatma Gandhi was kept in the prison. So the question of ancient, medieval and modern, what we study, this also partially supports the British view of history. Hope you understood. Now let us move to the topic, colonialism. Colonialism means, to be specific, a powerful country controls another country in what aspects? Political, economic, social and cultural aspects. So a economically or militarily powerful country controls the administration of a weak nation, that is called colonialism. Here direct administration, for example, British controlled India, so India was the colony and British were the colonial masters. Hope you understood the topic. So till now we completed James Mill's classification of history, problems of Mill's classification of history. We also studied about the classification of history into ancient, medieval and modern, and the meaning of colonialization or colonialism. One plus point which we learned from the British is the system of maintaining official records. Today, for example, when you enter the Chinese school Bijapur, in your name one personal file is opened. In that personal file, your complete detail which you submitted during admission, and after that the copy of your result, copy of your outpass, each and everything, including if you are involved in discipline activities, and everything will be recorded in a personal file. And this personal file you can also access from the school even after you passed out from Science School Bijapur. This system of record keeping, initially it was not there in India. So British started the system of record keeping in administration. Every instruction, that is plan, policy, decision, agreement, investigation, these are all clearly written by the British, and this is how they taught us how to make official records and the procedures. So to preserve the documents, the British first started the National Archives of India, which is in 1920s. So very main purpose was to preserve the documentation. So one plus point what we learned from British is this one, that is maintaining the documents. Because why we fail in Indian history, mainly why we fail, because we don't have much records. One of the reason is that during the British rule, the printing press was invented. That's the reason why writing or keeping, preserving document was very easy. But prior to that, preserving document was very difficult, because you studied in class 6 that writing in the metals or stones, it's very difficult. So that is also one of the reason. But one plus point that we learned the system of record keeping by the British. Hope you understood the topic of James Mill's classification of history, the division of history into three periods, and why it is not followed, and what are the problems of Mill's classification of history. Leftover topics and the question and answer, let us study in the next video session. This chapter, of course, very well there for your monthly test 1. Thank you.